Hi dear students, today we are going to continue promotion and advertising, lecture 1 and lecture 2. Chapter 5 is about the communication process. We have different and several objectives for this chapter. The first one describes the communication process and its role in integrated market communication and describes the basic model of the communication process. We discuss the role of word of mouth influence and viral marketing, and actually the three objective it will be deleted. You have to excluding from your exam inshallah. Last time as well we discuss objective number 4. It's analyze receiver response to marketing communication and their implication for promotion and planning and strategy. Objective number 5 as well, it's deleted, excluding from your titles. And today actually we are going to discuss the consumer cognitive processing of marketing communication. As we mentioned last time, as we discussed actually the response process, and I told for you that is in order to develop effective communications, we have to understand the response process of the consumers, how the consumers actually or how the receiver may go through in moving toward the specific behavior, and how the promotional effects that the marketeer actually use might affect or might influence this process. يعني كل يهم من الحقيقة في response process ده اللي احنا to understand ال response ال receiver process our response process for the receivers, how the consumers actually purchase the product or like the product, and how the different promotion effects that the marketer actually use affect such as this model, this process. As we mentioned, we have two types of models in order to understand such as this response. The first one, traditional response, a hierarchical model, and the second one, alternative as, or as I mentioned before, contemporary response models. الترديشنال response model as you can see here describe or for example shows that we have three stage اللي هي cognitive stage والaffective stage والbehavior stage, and I told you that the cognitive stage actually refers to or represent what the receivers know or perceive about the particular product or brand. هو عارف ايه عن البراند ديت او عارف ايه عن البرودكت ديت through بقى ال attentions وال awareness وال presentations that you are going to actually to provide to them. وال affective stage actually refers to what receivers feeling or affect level for the particular brand. وديت اللي هي after actually you provided your consumer information that they needed or you let the consumer aware about your product, they are going to shaping their feeling or their attitude towards the brand. وده includes هنا the strong levels of affect and such as desire or preference or convictions. وآخر حاجة عندك اللي هي الـ behavior stage, ودي الحقيقة refers to the consumer's action towards the brand. They are going to try the product, they are going to purchase, how they are going to adapt it, they are going to reject or not all of these behavior. عشان كده هو بيقول لحضرتك الـ behavior stage. It doesn't matter actually to be actual stage. وعندنا الحقيقة four models in order actually to what? In order to study the three stage. And each model actually completely different to the others, not in the not only on the process on the stage. لا هو مش بيختلفوا في ال stage. هما ال four actually model they are going to actually go through the three stage. لكن they will be quite different related how they can the technique. هيبقى مثلا في الكوجنيتيف ستيج في اتنشن في الـ ولا هيبقى في اويرنس، الافكتيف هيبقى فيها انترست وحاجه تانية ولا لا. وايه هم الفور مودلز كده سريعا، وي كان ريفيو. عندنا عايده موديل which actually develop in order to present the stage a salesperson must take a customer through an in the personal selling process. هي اكثر more beneficial for the marketeer if they are going to use الحقيقه ال personal selling process. وعند حضرتك ال hierarchies of effect models وديت it will be very important if you are going to actually to use ال promotion sales promotions أو ال ads. وعند حضرتك ال adaptation innovation adaptation models it will be useful for you if you are going to launch the product for the first time in the marketing. وال information processing model this is the last one ودي برضو if you are going to use اللي هو technology products or you are going to sell the product through different different channels. The response process of these slides actually show you how to evaluate the traditional response hierarchies model. هو بيقول لحضرتك هنا ان all four of these models view the response process as a consisting of movement through a sequence of three basic stages and assume a similar ordering whereby cognitive development precede affective reaction which in turn precede behavior. وزي ما قلت لحضرتك we have only three stage اللي هو cognitive stage والaffective stage والbehavior stage. ودولت هيبقوا معانا على طول، يعني ال three actually stage دولت هيبقوا معانا على طول. السكند اللي هو الالترناتيف ريسبونس موديل، وده يعني we have here an assumptions that not all the consumers actually they are going to follow the same sequence in order actually to purchase the product. Some people actually they are going to purchase the product first and then learn and then or they will be actually aware and after that they are going to actually to shaping their attitude. وهو ده اللي هو عايز يقوله. He while this is a logical progression that may be accurate in many situations, the response sequence may not always operate this way. That is why attentions need to be given to alternative order of the sequence hierarchy. وده لحضرتك هنا exam. Research over the past two decades has led to questions of the cognitive affective cognitive sequence of the response process has a result in the development of the alternative ordering this stage or not. طيب وبيقول لحضرتك ان السيكونس ده اللي هو اللي هما الثري ستيج اللي احنا ماشيين عليهم اللي هو الكوجنيتيف والافكتيف والبيهيفير ديبند اكشلي اون تو دايمنشن or in two parts. The perceived product differentiation, how the consumer actually perceive the differences among the products, with the product involvement, how the consumers actually will be involved when they are going to purchase the product. وبيزد بقى على ال two dimension دولت الحقيقة عندنا three types of models. يبقى ال alternative response model أو ال أو اللي أنا بسميها الحقيقة contemporary response model. Suppose as I mentioned that not all the consumer moving through the same sequence and this is based on two dimension perceived product differentiation وال product involvement. وبالتالي أنا عندي second الحقيقة models it will be dissonance attribution hierarchies. وهنا in some situation consumer may behave first then develop attitude or feeling as a result of their behavior and learn or process information that support their attitude and behavior. يعني ايه باختصار كده you are going to purchase firstly okay based on your friends recommendations or your past your good past experience with the product and after that trying to what to shape positive attitude towards your decisions and trying actually to gather information in order to support your decision. انا هنا اشتريت وبعد كده بقول حلو ده جميل ولطيف وبتدور بقى على looking for what for any information support your idea or support your decision. That is why here the consumer go through what do feel learn. وده الحقيقة بنسميها selective learning. Why selective learning before after the purchase? You would love actually to reduce the distance, the confused, the conflicts that you have been in. By what? By looking for other information support your decisions. أنا هنا ببقى متوتر، خايف، قلقان، يا ترى أنا اشتريت صح ولا غلط، يا ترى أنا اشتريت اللابتوب ده فعلا كان ولا كان المفروض اشتري التاني. فبتدور على أي معلومات in order to support your decision. That is why here the distance or the attribution hierarchy consists of do, feel, learn sequence where consumer must choose between two alternatives that are similar in quality but as well are complex and may have hidden or unknown attribute. The consumer may purchase here it on the basis of recommendation by some non-media source. Oh, what does it mean? Some non-media source, maybe your friends, maybe your family, maybe actually your past experience, okay? And then attempt to support the decision by developing a positive attitude towards the brand and a negative feeling towards the rejected alternative. You are looking for information in order to support your attitude, or, sorry, in order to support your decision. انا اشتريت البراند ديت، فانت عمال بتدور، شفتي اهو بيقولوا على البراند دي كويسة، بيقولوا على البراند فعلا دي احسن من ديت، واي حاجة بقى واي معلومة related to your negative feeling you need it in order برضو to support what your decision. These hierarchies may occur when the consumer what are trying to reduce post-purchase distance that resulted from doubt or concern over purchase. أهوت after you purchase you would love actually to reduce what your post purchase dissonance اللي هو الكونفليكت اللي انت بتبقى فيه، الهسهس اللي بيبقى عندنا كلنا لما نشتري حاجة مثلا غالية، ماشي، ونبقى يا ترى احنا عملنا كده صح ولا غلط. اوكي such as this dissonance reduction process involves what selective learning whereby the receiver seek information that support the choice made and avoids information that doesn't bolster the wisdom of the decisions. كمان حاجة تانية هو هيقولها كمان شوية. According to this model, marketer need to recognize that in some situation attitude develop after purchase as it does learning from the mass media. كمان في حاجة the model suggests that in situation the main effect of the mass media is not the promotion of original choice behavior and attitude change but rather the reduction of dissonance by reinforcing the wisdom of the repurchase or providing support information. As with the standard learning model, this response hierarchy is likely to occur when the consumer is involved in the purchase situation. It's particularly relevant for post-purchase situation. For example, a consumer may purchase tires recommended by a friend and then develop a favorable attitude towards the company and pay close attention to its ad to reduce distance. Marketeer here, communications planners, marketing communication planners here must be aware of the need for the advertising and promotion efforts, not just to encourage brand selections, but to reinforce the choices and ensure that a particular pattern will continue. أنا هنا بعمل إيه؟ As a marketeer الحقيقة, I have to focus on the advertising and the promotion, not to encourage the people to purchase my brand. لا. Or to encourage brand selection by to reinforce choices عشان تدعم ال choices بتاعتهم and ensure that a particular pattern will continue. لازم تدعم تديهم على طول حاجات تدعم ان ال choice بتاعهم ده كان صح in order to reduce ال business اللي عندهم. طيب low involvement third model or third actually types low involvement hierarchies. Low involvement hierarchies actually is thought to characterize the situation of low consumer involvement in the purchase process. من اسمها كده باينه قوي انها related to what related to the low consumer involvement in the purchase process. What does it mean low consumer involvement in the purchase process? Cheaper price, okay, rather than the other brand, okay, they will not actually gather more information in order to purchase. they will not actually spend a lot of time to purchase or comparing among the others. وهنا بيبقى passive learning أكتر، ال random information اللي بتجيله بتبقى هنا أكتر، يعني the people actually maybe they are going to focus on the advertising, the televisions, others issues, okay, الميوزك، الموديل، الكرياتيفيتي بتاعت المسج، rather than actually to focus on the information about the product. Okay. The response hierarchy is more under low involvement consists of what learn هو do وفل. Learn do وفل. أنا هنا I'm going to gather our information and then purchase وبعد كده I'm going to shaping my attitude. The response hierarchy is under low involvement consists of learn, do, feel sequence and the receiver is viewed as what engaging in a passive learning and random information catching rather than active information seeking. ما هي أصل حاجة أصل it's not actually very interest. The product that I'm going to actually to purchase is not very interest for me. It's not very expensive. Maybe actually it's cheaper rather than the other products. Okay, that is why I will not actually spend a lot of time in order to gather information. عشان كده هو من الكلام low hierarchy, low involvement hierarchy. Such as this hierarchy tend to occur when involvement in the purchase decision is low and there are minimal differences among the brand artists and the mass media advertising is important here. زي بالظبط ايه؟ زي برسيل وتايد. برسيل وتايد الحقيقة هما low involvement products. You will not actually gather a lot of information in order to evaluate between them. لا مش هيحصل. وكمان as a consumer is actually you view يعني minimum or few differences among the brand. يعني ما فرقتش برسيل من اريال من اوكسي من حاجات تانية، هي مش فرقة كتير. والماس ميديا هنا it will be very important in order to what in order to provide information يعني to take the يعني to help the consumer to take their decision. The notions of a low involvement hierarchy is based in large part on a theory which explaining the effect of television's advertising. By the way الحقيقة الكوميرشال الحاجة المهمة هنا في الموضوع ده ان الادفرتايزر must recognize that a passive و uninterest consumer may focus more on non-message elements such as music, character, samples and the slogan or jungle than actual message content. انا هنا الحقيقة as a consumer I will not focus on the information related to the product. لا انا يهمني حاجات تانية. Maybe I'm going to focus on other or non-message elements such as the music مثلا. موبينيل ما زي او اورنج زي فودافون، لكن انت دايما بتبص على other elements. فودافون for example السبونسر هي السبونسر مثلا بتاع احد الاندية اللي انت بتحبها، بتعمل لك حفلات مثلا عمرو دياب لحاجة تانية، فكل الحاجات دي you are very interesting. The advertiser must capitalize on this situation by developing a catchy shingle that is stored in the consumer mind without any active cognitive processing and becomes silent when he or she enters the actual purchased situations as well. اهوت دي حاجات، دي حاجة كمان مهمة جدا ان ال advertiser هنا might capitalize on this by the capitalize on this situation by developing a catch jungle. أنا بعمل هنا إيه؟ I'm going to link between the brand or my product and any others. For example, simple or music or character. In order to what? In order to leave the consumer always think about my product. Advertise of low involvement product also repeated simple product claims such as a key copy point or distinctive product benefit. Repetition of simple products claim increasing consumer memory and of and believe in those claims. In addition, advertise of low involvement products might find it more profitable to persuade a heavy repetition strategy than to reach a larger audience with lengthy, more detailed message. وادي لحضرتك هنا مثال بتاع هاينز. هاينز has dominated the ketchup market for over 30 years by repeatedly telling consumers that his brand is the ticket and reach thicked. Sorry. That is their brand is thick and richest. Heinz has used different of advertising campaign over the years. However, they all have communicated the same basic message that Heinz is the best and the most preferred brand of ketchup. أو يعني طول عمرنا هي دي اللي دايما بيفكر بهاينز مثلا ان هي thick وفي نفس الوقت rich. فأول الكامبين it should be what communicated in the same message. وده لحضرتك ان هو بيربط هنا اللو انفولفمنت ادفرتايزنج ابيل بريفيل ان ماتش اوف ذا ادفرتايزنج وي سي فور فريكوينتلي بيرشيز كونسيومر برودكت ساتش از ا كونسيومر باكج جود ايتش اوف ذيز ابيلز از ديزاينت تو هيلب كونسيومر ميك ان اسوسيشن ويزاوت ريلي اتامبت تو فورميليت اور شينج ان اتيتيود. Advertiser as well often use simple visual image that will lead consumer to identify and retain ads. أنا هدي لحضرتك مثال كمان على الموضوع ده. دايما مثلا رابطين اريال بممثلة أو ب one of the celebrity. فأنت على طول رابط مثلا one of the detergent by one of the celebrity which always what use in order to do the marketing campaign for this detergent. انت على طول فاكره. زي مثلا مستر ماسلز اللي هو اللي هو something actually which watch the toilet and the other for example issues. فانت هنا رابط ما بين ده وده. زي كورنفليكس when you use for example bird as a sample or as a character in order to link between the brand and the consumers to let them remember always cornflakes. Okay, implication of the alternative response model provide insight into promotional strategy. Marketeer much persuades in different situation. The marketeer should analyze the following: the involvement level and the products service differentiation. The consumer uses of different information sources. Sorry. Well, consumer levels of experience with the product or service as well. بيوري لحضرتك هنا ال 3 models according to the alternative responses hierarchies based on the 2 dimension اللي هو product involvement عندنا high and عندنا low وعندنا ال perceived product differentiation اللي هو ال high وال low. الحاجة التانية اللي هنتكلم فيها اللي هي cognitive processing of communications. والحقيقة هنا كل اللي كان يهمنا الفترة اللي فاتت ان احنا to study a response to the marketeer to the marketing communications. ودي كانت بالنسبة لنا مهمة. ال cognitive الحقيقة process it's very important for us as a marketeer. Okay. For many years, the hierarchy's response model were primary focus of approach to studying receiver response to marketing communications. Okay. والحقيقة ان cognitive processing هنا concern how the external information such as the advertising message is transformed into meaning or patterns of thought and how these meanings are combined to form judgment. انت زي ما قلنا ان احنا عندنا 3 stage. Cognitive وعندنا الافكتيف وعندنا الحياة البيهيفير. اللي تهمنا الحياة قوي هي الكوجنيتيف. why? because the consumer according to this one you are going to provide information to the consumer and the, through message. يعني انت دلوقتي عايز تقول لهم مثلا لازم تغسلوا ايديكم. ف according to that you have to put it in message. او عايز تقول لهم مثلا الفيروس ده مؤذي فخليكم قاعدين في البيت فانت بتحط الكلام ده في مسج. How the consumers, how the receivers they are going actually to perceive the message and they transform into meaning in order to take their decisions, in order actually to judge or evaluate or evaluated actually their decision. This is very important. هو ده اللي يهمنا في الحالة دي. That is why attention center on identifying relationship between specific control variables such as source and message factors and outcome or response variable such as attention or comprehension. This is very important. وبالتالي احنا هنا الحقيقة we would love to understand the nature of the cognitive processing of advertising and the other persuasive communication. عايزين نشوف the effect of the message on the others الحقيقة ايه response. How the consumer is actually will shaping their attitude and how the attitude actually it will affect their purchasing او هل الاتيتيود ديت it's او for example how such is this message actually affect not only attitude towards the ad but as well attitude towards the brand and both of them how they are going to actually to affect purchasing for the consumer. This is very important. عشان كده بيقول لحضرتك in response to this concern, research began trying to understand the nature of cognitive reaction to persuasive message. Cognitive processing concerned how external information, such as advertising message, is transformed into meaning or pattern of thought and how these meanings are combined to form judgment. والحقيقة أو in addition, we have several approach and model have been developed to examine. The nature of consumer cognitive of advertising message. تعال نشوف بقى الموضوع شكله ازاي. Commonly, a cognitive response approach is a commonly used method for examining consumer cognitive processing. يبقى احنا what we are going to do, we are going to test the first stage related to the three stage اللي هي ايه cognitive processing of advertising message is through the assessment of their cognitive response or thought. احنا هنعمل ايه هنا؟ هنعمل assessment للconsumers او للreceiver cognitive response or thought. How or how it will be happen? It will be happen actually when the people read or view or hearing any communication tools. شايف بالبورد for example, بتقرأ advertising, printed advertising, viewing for example television ads or for example social media. How it will be your response when you are going to actually to be exposures to any of these messages. These thoughts are generally measured by what having consumer write down or verbal report their reaction to message. How we are going to measure? We are going to ask the consumers actually to write down their impressions, their reaction towards the message. How in them verbal they can report what they or what about their reaction. The assumption here is that these thoughts reflect the recipient cognitive process or reaction and the help shape unlimited acceptance or rejection of the message. أنا هنا بعمل إيه؟ الحقيقة I give them the opportunity in order to what? In order actually to know the consumer reaction وhelp in هو to shape unlimited acceptance or reaction of the message. It focus have been to determine the type of response evoked by an advertising message and how this response related to traditional outcome measure such as attitude towards the brand or attitude towards the ad and then purchase. دي هو بيوري لحضرتك هو ده اللي احنا بنتكلم عليه. السلايد ديت depicts the three basic category of cognitive response researchers which have been identified and how they may related to attitude and intention. بص يا فندم according للبتاع ده according للfigure احنا we let the consumer see or read or view for example any advertisement or exposure to advertisement type. When you are going to read such as this message, we have three type of cognitive response. ايه هما three type of cognitive response? عندنا product message thought, وعندنا source oriented thought, وعندنا ad execution thought. هقول تاني. We let the consumers actually export the consumer to advertising. We provide them a message. The message diet or cognitive response diet three types: product message thought, وسورس مسج وسورس اورينتد ثوت واد اكسكيوشن ثوت. اعتبر ان دولت كونسيدر ان الثري تايب دولت ريليتد وات ريليتد تو ذا كوجنيتيف ريسبونس. بعد ما بتقرا الاعلان ده اللي حاجه من الثلاثه دولت اللي بتبقى في دماغك أو you are being aware about it or you are being interest about. وهنشوف إزاي كمان شوية. And how بقى each one affect the attitude اللي هو إيه الأفكت في stage اللي إحنا كنا أخدناه قبل كده. How مثلا a product message sold affect the brand attitude or affect the attitude towards the ad. ونفس الكلام the source oriented ونفس الكلام the ad execution. And how the attitude both of the brand and both of the advertisement affect what the purchase intention. وده اللي هو عايز يوصله. يبقى احنا دلوقتي we provide information for the consumer through the advertisement. In order actually to know how they will be react, we have to think about the cognitive response. According to that, the consumer actually can transform the meaning بتاع message through one of the three cognitive response. هو دلوقتي بياخد المعلومة من الادز ويحولها للكوجنيتيف ريسبونس ده اللي هي product message thought ولا source oriented thought ولا ad execution thought. And we are going to know how it will affect the attitude will purchase intention. طيب نبتدي. البرودكت والمسج الصوت الحقيقه ده الفيرست كاتيجوري اوف ثوت كومبرايزز ذوز دايركتد ات ذا ات ذا برودكت اور سيرفيس اند اور ذا كليمز برينج ميد ان ذا كوميونيكيشنز. يعني ايه يا دكتور؟ يعني الحقيقه ده الفيرست كاتيجوري وهنا اول ذا انفورميشن دايركت وات to the product. All the information related to the product and it will be claimed being made in the communications. Okay. وعندي هنا الحقيقة two kinds of two types of response. Counter agreements و support agreement. طب ايه هو counter agreement ده؟ That are thought that the recipients has that are opposite to the position taken in the message. تاني are thought the recipient has that are opposite to the position taken in the message. وطبعا relate negatively to the message acceptance. يعني ايه؟ يعني انا as a consumer الحقيقة هو جايب لك حتى الاكزامبل هاي. for example consider ad for ultra tight show for showing in this figure actually consumer may express disbelief or disapproval of a claim made in ad. I don't believe that any detergent could get that satin out. هما بيقولوا الحقيقة إن Tide ده vanish any spots. لكن أنا الحقيقة I have another belief. اللي إيه هو البليف؟ I don't trust any detergent to get satin out. يبقى ده اسمه إيه؟ اسمه counter agreement. Product message thought counter agreement اللي هو الثوت الأفكار that we have actually as a consumer in our mind opposed or against the position which is taken in the message. وبالتالي according to that I will not actually accept the message. أنا هو عمال يقول ده بيعمل ساتان out. لا 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 أنا مش مقتنعة بكده. That is why I will not accept what or I have a negative attitude towards the ads. I am not actually I don't trust this ad. التاني بقى اللي هو support agreement العكس contains the information or meaning the source hopes to convey thought that affirms the claims made in the message. هنا بقى I believe that there is a difference among the detergent and one of them should what let that satin out or vanish the spots. فهنا such this ad it will be what it will support my belief, it will support my convictions. Other consumer who sees this ad may generate support agreement or thought that affirms the claim made in the message. That is why it will be relative what positive. فأنا في الحالة ديت I'm going to accept المسج. ليه؟ لأنه هو consists with my belief. Okay. طيب The light code of counter agreement is greater when the message may claim that oppose the receiver belief. For example, how would the consumer viewing commercials that attack a favorite brand is likely to engage in counter agreement. دي حقيقة. Attack a favorite brand is likely to engage in. أنا شايف إن هو مثلا زي مثلا الحاجات اللي بتيجي ما بين بيرسيل وأريال. لا أنا مقتنع مثلا إن بيرسيل much stronger rather than أريال. فأنا شايفة إن أنا كده لا مش بحب أريال مثلا. أوكي. Thus, counter agreement relate negatively to the message acceptance. The more the receiver and counter agree, the less the likely he or she is accept the position advocate in the message. Support agreement, طبعا, on the other hand, related positively to the message acceptance. Therefore, the marketer should develop ads or other promotional message that minimize the counter agreeing and encourage support agreements. Okay, this is the role of our market. ده أول types من الكوجنيتيف ريسبونس. تاني the third one اللي هو ال ad execution related suit. ده consist of institutions thought about the ad bill itself. هنا بقى ال information or the suit related to the ad or the elements of the ad. Music, creative ads, message شكلها ايه, model, color, resolutions, lighting, all of these issues. The ad execution related thought consists of the individual thought about the ad itself, contains the information or meaning the source hopes to convey. Many of the thought receivers have when reading or viewing an ad don't concern the product and or message claim directly. هو هنا الحقيقة don't what? Don't الحقيقة يعني concentrate on the product. Or the information related to the product. لا هو شايف حاجة تانية خالص. هو concentrated on other issues, on other elements. They are effective reactions represent الحقيقة the consumer feeling towards the ads. هو النوع ده الحقيقة more emotional. عشان كده هو بيقول لحضرتك they are effective reaction representing the consumer feeling toward the ads. Ad execution related so can be easier favorable or non-favorable. They are important because of their effect on attitude towards the advertisement as well as well the brand. هنا الميوزك الكرياتيف بتاع الكرياتيفيتي بتاعة الإعلان نفسه, المودلز, اللايتنج, all of these issues actually it will affect the consumer feeling or the consumer attitude towards the ad as well as the brand. برضو دولت اللي هم تلات انواع, وبرضو لسه بيتكلم how بقى according to the model اللي احنا شفناه الحقيقة how three type of cognitive response it will affect the attitude towards ad. هنا represent the receiver feeling or favor or unfavor towards the ad. Advertisers are interested in consumer reaction to the ad because they know that the affected reactions are important determinants of advertising effectiveness. Since these reactions may be transferred to the brand itself or directly influence purchase intention. هما الحقيقة الادفرتايزر بيهتموا بالحاجات اللي هي فيها emotional. وهو دي اللعبة اللي دايما بيلعبوها because actually they manipulated by the consumer mind by the emotions. Okay, in order to affect their attitude towards the brand and towards the advertising. وادي حضرتك مثال على الموضوع ده, الإعلان مثلا بتاع هاني رمزي. اوكي بتاع اللي هو كوتونيل والكلام ده, most of the people actually they don't like, they have a negative attitude toward the brands and as well toward the advertising. اوكي فهو برغم ان most of the people they engage in conversations toward the ad and toward the advertising but they have a negative attitude. اوكي زي الاعلان مثلا لما يتعمل بتاع اي حاجه تانية, اعلان بتاع بيبسي, اعلان بتاع كوكولا, تبقى الناس منبهره باللايتنج, منبهره بمحمد صلاح وهو بيلعب مع ميسي, بيلعب ازاي الكلام ده كله, ده بيأثر على الايموشنز بتاعه الناس, وتبقى عايز اشوف الاعلان بتاع محمد صلاح عامل فيه ايه. The importance of affective reaction and feeling generated by the ad depend on several factors. Among them, the nature of the ad and the type of processing engaging the receiver as well. Many advertisers now use emotional ads designed to evoke feeling and affect reaction as the basic of their creative strategy. اهوت احنا لسه كنا بنقول احنا بنستخدم ال emotional ads in order to what? To affect the feeling of the people. The success of this strategy depends in part of the consumer involvement with the brand and their likelihood of attending to and processing the message as well. One of the issues as well, it will be what? Elaborations likelihood model. The elaborations likelihood model, it's a tool in order actually to understand the cognitive processing. Okay. فهو بيقول لحضرتك الـ Liberation Likelihood Model of Perceptions is a dual process theory describes the change of attitude, how the people change their attitude toward the brand or toward the ad. Focus on what? Focus on the differences in the way consumer process and the response to persuasive message. وبيقول لحضرتك برضو ان الموديل ده aim to explain different ways of processing stimuli. Why they are used and their outcome on outside. يبقى هو هنا بيركز على ايه ال change بتاع ال attitude. How the consumer actually changes their attitude. The attitude formations or change process depend on the amount and the nature of the elaborations or processing or relevant information that occur in the response to a persuasive message. يبقى هنا in order to change the attitude of the people ده بيعتمد الحقيقة على ال amount and natures of elaborations or processing of relevant information how you are going to elaborate it related to the information هنا that the marketer provided for you. وعندنا حاجتين, عندنا high elaborations وعندنا low elaborations. The high elaboration means that the receiver engage in a carefully consideration thinking and the evaluation of the information or arguments contained in the message. هتلاقيه هنا في some consumer they are very carefully when they are going to actually to gather the information and the thinking. ده حتى احنا بنسميه اللي هو ايه logic thinking. انا بجمع معلومات عن المنتج بتاعي in order to what? In order to think how I will judge such as these and for how I will purchase such as this product. Low elaborations occur when the receiver doesn't engage in active information processing or think, but rather makes inferences about the position being advocated in the message on the basis of the simple positive or the negative cue. هنا it doesn't matter actually to use what or to gather information about the product. لكن المهم عندي الميوزك, المهم عندي مثلا المودلز, اللايتنج, الاعلان كان كرييتيف ولا لا. This is what we call low elaborations. وفي نفس الوقت ال elaboration likelihood is a function of two dimensions. ايه هما ال two dimensions? ال motivations will ability. ال motivation to process the message depend on such factors as involvement, personal relevance and the individual's need and the arousal level. وال ability depends that you have ال ability that you have actually knowledge or ability actually to engage in such these process or not. Our ability depends on the individual knowledge, intellectual capacity and the opportunity to process the message related to the times available to the individual to make a decision. وفي نفس الوقت عندنا two routes. اهو focus on the way consumer responds to persuasive message. هو الكونسيومر هياخد اللوجيكال مسج اللوجيكال روت اللي هو اللي احنا هنسميه سنترال روت ولا البريفيربل روت اللي هو الايموشنال روت. اوكي, فالليبريشن لايك هود موديل هنا focus on the way consumer responds to persuasive message based on the amount and the nature of the elaboration of processing information. وهنا عندنا we have two routes in order to change the attitude of the consumers or in order to understand how the consumer changes their attitude. Central route will preferable route. طب تعالى نبص كده, بص حضرتك على الفيجر ده. ادي هو الليبريشنز موديل ده اتعمل الحقيقة 1979، وده السنترال باث، ده الروتس اللي احنا الادي الموتيفيشنز والابيليتي بتاعت الناس. if you have a need I need a car for example، والابيليتي الابيليتي that you have money and you are going to actually to spend time actually to gather information. وعندنا two routes، السنترال باث اهوت اوكي، والبريفرال باث. السنترال باث لايك وات؟ thinking logic. انا هنا I am going to actually to think as a mature person و think I need a car. طيب the price is great. طيب يا ترى البرايس شكله ازاي؟ طيب ايه هي الحاجات اللي انا عايزاها؟ عايزاها high performance top car of the year. طب في الحالة دي I have to get information about the top car of the year. البرشبل ده بيعتمد على الكيوز الفير والديزايرز. اوكي okay. I just need a car. انا مش مشكله عندي هي شكلها ايه، مش مشكله عندي البرايس شكله ايه. يا ترى اللي في الاعلان ديت بنت حلوه ولا لا، انا اقدر اشتري ولا لا. ماشي this is a car for me. يبقى في الحاله ديت هي دي الكار كويس. هنا الاولويات وهاي بيرفورمانس. هنا اولوياته الحقيقه كان هو can I pay or not. يعني ده السنتر باس اهو، الاولويه بتاعته ان انا عايز الحقيقه برايس، عايز هاي بيرفورمانس كار. اوكي هنا انا مش مشكله عندي اشتري او ما اشتريش، ده ديزاير، انا بس عايزها كده عشان تو شو اوف ذا بيبل. وهنا I can pay or not. اوكي برضو ديت او الفيجر اللي جاي هيوضح لنا هنا السنتر باس. هنا I'm going to think about the cost, the insurance cost, the safety والريتيلينج والريابيليتي والريفيوز والفول efficiency. هنا لا بفكر في حاجات تانية خالص، بفكر في حاجات emotional اكتر. اوكي فالكالر والفلافي داي سبيد والسكس ابيل والبيج ويلز والكلام ده كله اهوت. السنترال روز the receiver is viewed as a very active. Oh, it's very active. It means actually that you are going to gather more information about the product, involve participant in the communication process, ability and motivation to process the message, attend, comprehend and evaluate. هنمشي بقى اللي هي الخطوات العادية اللي هو فيها cognitive و you are being aware about the brand, you would love actually to gather information, you are going to evaluate. وده are high. الابيليتي والموتيفيشن الاثنين ار هاي. ذا كونسيومر هنا بي كلوز اتنشن تو مسج كونتين اند سينكرونيتي ذا مسج اجريمنتس. يعني انت هنا ككونسيومرز الحقيقه بي كلوز اتنشن للمسج كونتين اذا ار جون تو بروفايد ذا انفورميشن ذات يو نيدد اور نوت. A high level of cognitive response activities or processing occurs and the ability and the as ability to persuade the receivers depends primarily on the receiver evaluation of the quality of the argument presented. A favorable cognitive response support. هنا هنستخدم ايه؟ هنستخدم support arguments اهوت والsource clusters. يعني هنستخدم informations in order to be consistent with belief. وفي نفس الوقت هنستخدم source plus spoken person بقى who support or who has actually good reputation and support actually your idea. Lead to favorable change in cognitive structure which lead to positive attitude or persuasion. If the cognitive processing is unfavorable and result in counter agreement or source degradation, the change in cognitive structure are unfavorable and it will be boring or result in negative attitude change. ده بالنسبة للcenter root. Preferable route, the receiver sees view as the lacking the motivations or ability to process information and is not likely to engage in detailed cognitive processing. The ability or motivations هنا هتبقى قليلة. Okay? والconsumers actually they will not actually gather information. هو مش بالنسبة له الموضوع ده مهم. يعني it's just I need a car خلاص. Receiver focus more on perishable cues than a message contains that may be insidelent to the main agreement. أنا هنا it doesn't matter for me الحقيقة information related to the product. It doesn't matter for me others non-elements message. The receiver reaction to the message depends on how he or she evaluates these perishable cues. Favorable attitude may be formed if the endorse in the ad is viewed as an expert or is attractive or likable, or if the consumer likes certain execution aspects of the ad, such as the way it's made, the music, or the. أنا قلت لحضرتك هنا إحنا بندور على حاجات تانية، إحنا بندور على content تاني. الفيجر ده بيوري لحضرتك how الإليبريشن like good model of persuasions. ده الإمبليكيشنز بتاعتها of the ELM. Consumer feel of level, customer level of involvement has important implications for marketing communications. ال high involvement, احنا في لو عندنا high involvement, sales position should contain agreements that are difficult to refute. With low involvement, perishable queue are more important than detailed message agreement. السليبرتي هنا هيلعبوا دور مهم جدا, we are going to discuss later ان شاء الله. When the receiver involvement was high, however, the use of the celebrity had no effect on brand attitude. The quality of the message claim becomes more important than the identity of the endorsers. Effectiveness of the message depends on customer route to persuasion. Many marketers recognize that the involvement level are low for their product or category, and consumer are not motivated to process advertising message in any details. That is why marketeer of low involvement products often rely on creative tactics that emphasize preferable cue and use repetitive advertising to create and to maintain favorable attitude towards the brand. هنا بقى بيوري summary الكل اللي حصل في الشابتر الحقيقة. Three critical intermediate effects between advertising and purchase, اللي هو cognitive والaffective والexperience. Cognitions اللي هو thinking, refer to the thinking dimensions. Affect اللي هو feeling, والexperience اللي هو feedback dimension based on purchasing. Effect of advertising should be evaluated using these three dimensions as I mentioned. وهنا important to learn as much as possible about target audience and how it may be responsive to advertising and the other form of